We now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit instructs the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to be truly wise and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord.
Jesus proposed a parable to the crowds. The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, "Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." His slaves said to him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" He replied, "No. If you pull up the weeds, you might have pulled the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, 'First, collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Good afternoon, good morning, and good evening. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I missed yesterday the sharing about the parents of Mary, Joachim and Anne, but I know you have done your sharing very well. So much so that we will continue today with the reading of the parable. It is the parable of the good seed sown in the field, but at the same time, the other seed, the bad seed, was also sown. And so there was the tendency of the servant leader to gather all the weeds, but the master said, "No, let them be as such. Let them grow together with the good weeds, so that at harvest time, we will say to the harvester, 'First, collect the bad seed or the bad weeds, and then tie them into burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" The good seed is always there. You know, the faith that we have is the good seed. The baptism that we have is the good seed. All of which allows us to realize the goodness of God, the mercy of God, the providence of God. So the seed is always there. But along the way, as we grow up, any seed can come, the seed of sinfulness. And we almost accept it. We have almost done it. The seed of sinfulness that is within us, it grows. It hastens, it becomes large, until at times we could not contain it. But you see, the harvest is there, waiting for the both weeds, so much so that we gather that one into the burning process or into the barn. What is good is that other is none other than the weeds are preeminent of our patience. There is patience in our life, and that patience should lead us to let grow the weeds of life, whatever would be the weeds, either the good or the bad. Precisely because at the end, the weeds would be gathered for the burning and the wheat for the barn. The patience of the weeds, the patience of the master, is all seen here. Kaya nga sabi ni Master, "No, you do not pull the weeds, because you might pull also, you might pull also the good ones. If you pull the good weeds, then the good one, the bad ones will also be pulled. Or if you pull the bad ones, the good ones will be pulled also. So what is enhanced here is the process of growth, is the process of reckoning. There will be always the two weeds in us, but at the end, we will allow only the good weeds to grow, so that we will burn the bad weeds, and the bad weeds will be burned into the fire everlasting. But the good weeds, it will be put into the barns because of the harvest. The enemy is always there. The enemy is always there. The enemy who will sow the weeds of bad things, the enemy who always sow the weeds of things that are not in accordance with the plan of God, with the will of God, so much so that it is hard at times. You know, children at times, or we are in the process, we have grown up and see all these things, how we are doing evil, but how we will do the good things as well. But for the good in us, we will see always the best things of life. We will see always the best things of God. We will see always the best proclamation of the gospel that animates us towards growing up, towards a better person, and towards a prompted person in the eyes of God. Let not the weeds, the bad weeds, grow in us as we allow ourselves to discover the will of God. Amen.
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 Almighty Father, thank you for your Son, Jesus.
Thank you for your Son, Jesus.
And the Holy Spirit.
To implant in us.
The good seed of life. We wonder where the weeds are. But we will let them grow.
So that at harvest time,
we will burn them. And we allow the harvest of wheat. Thank you, Lord, for this harvest of wheat.
Thank you, Lord, for this harvest.
To be placed in the barns of our life. We thank you, Lord, for the patience as well. That has grown as much. Lord, may we never come to the evil of life. But only proceed to the goodness of living. Because the goodness of living is your aim for us.
And that would be our proclamation.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Angel of God,
my guardian angel, to whom God's love commits me here,
ever this night be at my side, light and guard, rule and guide. Amen. Saint Hannibal,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony,
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Send, O Lord,
Holy Apostles into your church.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Good evening, good afternoon, and good morning.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Welcome po. Si Tomani is there already.
Lish, nakaabot ng blessing.
Yeah. Yeah. Timing. We started at 8:05 dito.
Ano na, wala ka na. Walang problema.
Yes po. Nandiyan naman si Tabel eh.
So, beautiful gospel once again.
So, any other reflection on the good weeds and the bad weeds?
You will see the patience of the master there.
You will see the patience of the master as he allowed growth for both. So that at harvest time, the bad weeds will be burned and the good weeds will be put into barn. So, tremendous patience of God for us.
We are given really many, many chances to be good.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the reason, Father, na evils or bad things happen in our life.
That's something. It's part of.
Because sometimes, I mean, it's a common question, no, na why are these bad things happening? Not only in our life, personal life, or makita natin in our surroundings ba?
Mm-hmm. It's the problem of suffering even. That all suffer, that all are manifesting evil in their part, that all are undergoing such things. But you know, good or evil, we are in the same lines. But the more important for us is the good things of God. We have all the sufferings as part of the evil one, but suffering can be also good in terms of our addressing it in the name of Jesus and in Jesus.
So that explains, Father, na in the present situation, no, in our modern life, no, that these things are allowed to happen, no, like what we have discussed earlier, no, about the abortion, about
divorce,
same-sex marriage, and some political chaos, ba?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh. So, example, ano, like the president, no, the president of China. How can God allow him to do and to decide to harm other people, no? Na parang it's impossible for him to ano. It's impossible for him to ask for forgiveness kasi hindi siya Christian. Iba ang religion niya. So, ito na lang, no? Iba siya eh. I mean, he doesn't believe in our faith. Can he ask for forgiveness kaya those who are who have committed sins, no? And they are not of the same faith sa atin. Non-Christian sila.
But, you know, because kaya, no? In many ways, if you are not a Christian, you believe in the goodness. The goodness is all over. So much so that if you have goodness, you know, you can ask, if you have done something wrong, you can ask perhaps forgiveness for that. Because of the goodness that is developed in us, the goodness that we see, the goodness that we do. So it's not only for Catholic, but it's all for everybody. It's all for everybody.
Example lang yan ang president of China and other leaders na who are really causing harm to other people like mga countries of Iran, mga China, mga Russia. Yun ang sometimes we ask, bakit kaya? I just hope, no? We keep on praying for them, for their conversion.
Amen.
Yes, we pray for them, and we pray also for us, for our conversion.
For our, our own conversion.
And now, for example, for the divorce, what can we do? We can write letters to the Congress. Or with our congressman, really talk with them and say that divorce is not for us. But if it is hard, you know, a letter can do to the Congress. It's still part of our role. It's still part of our role.
Pero the president can always veto naman eh. Hopefully. Kung mapas na na final na, and then pwede naman ma-veto yan ni president. I-veto niya. Oo. And, Catholic ba? Catholic si
yes,
Bibi.
Catholic siya.
Ah, Catholic siya.
Mm-hmm.
Si President Marcos dyan.
But it's nice still that it won't pass the Congress. But anyway, the Senate, we could work on that. We will wait for the Senate to work on that.
Kasi na ano na, na-pass na yata sa Congress, eh, tapos Senate na ngayon. No? Para na-pass na, naka-third reading na yata eh.
Third reading na ba, Tita Bel?
Yeah. I think, oo, third reading na.
Senate na lang, Father.
Senate na
lang. Senate na lang?
Kaya nga eh, just in case na mapas ng Senate, magiging law na yan.
Yeah, bicameral conference, and then to solve issues kung ano nando doon, tapos they forward it to the president.
Sana
well, we hope and pray that he will not sign.
Yun na lang pag-asa natin. And a lot of prayers. Pero many times nagin attempt nila, no? Father, no? Parang many times
nagin attempt. Many times it was attempted in the Congress, but the Congress did not work on it. Only this Congress has so much to do. But hopefully it will not solve kasi once it is, it will pass over to the next Congress. So, wala na.
Ano na lang yan, no? Catholic ang Philippines, no? 80%, 85% Catholic.
Less. Pero it's still a determining Christian factor. It's still a determining factor for us.
Oh. Pero I think para, I don't know, no, if they are not Catholic, no, especially dyan sa Philippines, do. They also believe in ano no one marriage lang even if they're not Catholic.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Except for the Muslims. Iglesia ni Cristo has one marriage.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, wherever we are, we have to pray more for the evil not to come, but the good things of the Lord in our life. Amen.
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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Good night.
Good night, Father. Thank you very much for the very, very nice reflections. Beautiful reflections. Please go ahead, Tito Man.
Kasabihan yun, nasa huli ang pagsisisi. Kasi kung nasa una, wala magkakamali. See? Nasa huli, pagsisisi. Amen.
Amen. Yeah, very true, Tito Manny. So, the three pointers, Tita Lynn.
The three pointers for today's gospel. In this parable, Jesus reminds us that God's kingdom in this world is constantly under attack by the evil one, whose goal is to corrupt, pollute, and undermine the work of Jesus. Number two, Jesus wants us to live a more vigilant and discerning life that is guided. One of the most common dangers of our spiritual life is to be contented and lukewarm in our faith, and as such, imperceptibly deceived by the lures of the evil spirits in our daily living. Number three, pray for the spiritual wisdom to recognize God's will and the strength to choose what leads to God, regardless of how difficult and painful the challenges may be. Amen.
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 Thank you very much, Sita Lynn. So that ends our Zoom prayer meeting for today, no? And let's keep on remembering the reflections of Father Danny, no? And also remind ourselves, no, that the weed, the evil, and the wheat, the good, can grow together. So let's be vigilant. Let's be vigilant. Kasi nga, the lure of the evil is very deceiving. Very, very deceiving. And then let's keep on praying for, you know, for the peace in the whole world, and to change the hearts of those, especially of those people, no, especially the leader of the nations. Amen.
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 The closing prayer.
Closing prayer. Almighty Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for the activities in honor of Blessed Mother Mary, guiding us to remain faithful into your commandments. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
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 And all together, please, glory be to the Father, and the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye. Love you guys.